Shalom from Eretz HaKodesh, Eretz Israel, to all my dear friends all over the world in general and in Israel in particular. This parasha is Parashat Tzri'a. As you know, today is Mamash Orev Rosh Chodesh, Thursday, Rosh Chodesh Iyar, which gives us a little bit of the light, Ora Ganuz, that we say a pasuk every morning after Tfilat Shachrit. Kol ha-mahala asher samti be-mitzrayim lo asim alecha ki ani Hashem rofeecha. All the diseases that I put in Egypt, I will never put on you. Because ani Hashem rofeecha. I am Hashem who cure you. Ani Hashem rofeecha, abbreviation Iyar, the month of Iyar, according to the Mekubalim, is the month of health, good health. So maybe Be'ezrat Hashem, this is the sign. And tonight is the Yortziat of Rabbi Chaim Vital. Rabbi Chaim Vital, we mention his name many, many times in our Shiurim. He is the Talmid number one of Ari HaKadosh. And tonight is his Yortziat. 400 years ago, Rabbi Chaim Vital was among us. And tonight, Mamash is 400 years. Remind us a little bit of Egypt. So, Be'ezrat Hashem, light candle tonight, midnight. Midnight is about 12:40 in Eretz Israel. And we light the candle in loving memory of Rabbi Chaim Vital, that if you remember, whoever was in my shiur, in the book B'Shem Magdolim of Ahida, Chaim Yosef David Azulai, that he wrote a biography book. He wrote about the Mashiach, and he hid in his story more than he revealed. And we don't have now the time. I would like to talk about the parasha, but I'd like to mention this. This is a very strong story, and that's in his book of Chaim Yosef David Azulai. You know that Hezekiah HaMelech, he was the one that had to lead the Jewish people when Sanherib, the king of Ashur, which Gog and Magog, we always say Sanherib, he was trying to destroy the whole world, mamash like Hitler. Every country he conquered and occupied. And he was waiting for the day to occupy Jerusalem. And everybody said to him to take Jerusalem. When he saw with his binoculars Jerusalem, he waved with his hand, say, Yenofef Yado, like piece of cake for me. And the Jews, of course, got scared to death. But Hezekiah HaMelech, not only he did not give up, he closed the water to Sanherib. By the way, today, if you go to visit in City of David, you see Nikbat Hezekiah, that's the tunnel underneath with water. That's the water he closed. He closed the water, not to give them water, and he closed the wall of Jerusalem. That was like a chutzpah for Sanherib, and he challenged him more. And Hezekiah said to his nation, we all know that Sanherib is very strong. We all know that he has a lot of soldiers, much more than we have, more weapons than we have. But we have something he doesn't have. Hashem is with us. Hashem imanu. If Hashem is with us, we will defeat him. And you know what happened. In Leil HaSeder, Sanherib came to conquer Jerusalem, and the Jewish people saying Hallel, in the Leil HaSeder, his foreign minister of Hezekiah, Belshazzar, he heard the Seder, the Leil HaSeder, the Hallel. He understood about Judaism, and he said, don't challenge them tonight. If they say Hallel in the night, you will never be able to defeat them. Sanherib, of course, did not understand what his foreign minister said. And he pushed him away. And we don't know what happened, but one thing we know, we got up in the morning and we saw 175,000 Syrian soldiers, 175 or 185, we can check, different is not big, dead on the ground without any war. Exactly as we say in the Seder, Hashem said, I'm going to hit them, ani velo shaliach, I am and not messenger. Ani velo malach, I'm not an angel. I myself hit them. And that was a big, big miracle that happened in Leila Seder. That was the end of the story of Sancheriv. Many, many years ago, later on, many, many years later, I'm sorry, many years ago from now, it was a man that controlled the Muslims world. His name was Abu Sayyaf. Abu Sayyaf means the owner of the sword. Whoever drove him crazy, he chopped his head off. No problem. That was Abu Sayyaf. Everyone was scared to death from him. And one day on Friday, when the Jews knew that the Muslims going to pray, and everybody was afraid of Abu Sayyaf, was hiding in his house. And then he heard water under the ground. When he heard the water, he asked explanation, what is water? So his people explained to him what happened with Chizkiyahu. And he said, he asked him, who can open this ground to have the water? I want to explain to you, open this ground. Everybody can open the ground, but he doesn't have many people can open. He said, to open the ground and get blessing in the water, to get good, pure water. And they said, there is only one man can do it. He is a great rabbi, big time rabbi among the Jewish community. And his name is Rabbi Chaim Vital. He is the only one. He said, call him right away. When Rabbi Chaim Vital came, and he said to Rabbi Chaim Vital, listen, your leader many years ago closed this water. You open it. I'm going out to pray. I'll be back and this open. If not, you are dead. That's what he said. And he left. Rabbi Chaim Vital has to make Sheilat Rav. Who is his rabbi? Ari Kadosh. But the rabbi, his rabbi Ari was in Damascus. So you know, for the Mekubalim, like Rabbi Chaim Vital, he combined few names, holy names, and he like flew. In 2 seconds, he was in front of Ari HaKadosh. Ari HaKadosh, when he saw him, he did not welcome him very nice. Rabbi Chaim Vital immediately understood that he did something wrong. He said, why you didn't open? He said, how could I open without asking you? He said, you missed it. So what do I mean? You missed the Mashiach. If you would open this water, you would really, really see the Mashiach. He said, I can do it now. No, it is too late. If you miss the Mashiach with one minute, it is too late. And he asked explanation of Ari HaKadosh, what's going on? He said to him, you are the spark of Chizkiyahu HaMelech. Chizkiyahu HaMelech was the Mashiach. And after big argument, because he did not say Hallel, after all the miracles that Hashem did with him, he was not the Mashiach. You are the Gilgul, the spark, but only spark, not full Gilgul, of Chizkiyahu HaMelech. This man, Abu Sayyaf, is the Gilgul of Sancheriv. There is big dispute if Chizkiyahu, what he did was good or bad. But you can fix what Chizkiyahu did. If you would open the water, you would redeem the Jewish people. But now it's too late. Rabotai, now I remember this story every time, Rosh Chodesh Iyar, you know, the Yortziat of Rabbi Chaim Vital. So let's light the candle tonight, 12:42 Israeli time, and Be'ezrat Hashem, Reb Chaim Vital will protect us and redeem us. Not only will stop the corona, not only will stop, he will bring the crown, not the corona. He will bring the crown to Hashem, And to say Hashem Melech, Hashem Malach, Hashem Mimloch Leolam Vaed, and he will bring the Mashiach with him. Maybe it's him, maybe it's somebody else. Now, all what we want is to really to bring the Mashiach. So I say this Shi'ur now is for his Elohim Neshama Reb Chaim Vital and Elohim Neshama of the 6 million Jews in the Holocaust, in the Shoah, and of course Elohim Neshama for all the Israeli soldiers who got killed during the wars of Israel since 1946 up to today. So this parasha is Parashat Tzriah. Yes, we have a chain of parashiot paragraph talking about purity and impurity, and it's going together with Mesorah, with the leprosy. I will like, and but the beginning, in the beginning, it starts with all the impurity. It starts with the woman who delivered a baby. And today, the subject going to be about this woman, the woman who delivered a baby. In Vayikra Perek Yudbet, chapter Yudbet, 12, Pasuk Bet, the second Pasuk, it says, Daber el bnei Israel emor, Isha ki tazrea v'yalda zachar v'tamea shivat yamim. If the Isha will deliver a baby boy, she will be impure for 7 days. So this is the beginning of the story of the Yoledet. You see, we start with, it's interesting, we'll talk about this later on. And now we'll see that not only the Yoledet, we'll see all different kind of purity and impurity. To understand the purity of human being, I would like to go with you to Pirkei Avot, which we also read between Pesach and Shavuot. And during this particular Mishnah that we learned already one time, whoever was with me, and after I will explain the Mishnah, we will go to see again the Yoledet. When I say Yoledet, means the woman who delivered the baby. A Mishnah in Masechet Avot talking about the Bet Midrash of Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai. Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai had 5 students. He had many, many students, but 5 powerful students. Would I say gifted students? And they were always with Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai. What their name? Their name was Rabbi Eliezer ben Hurkanus, Rabbi Yoshua ben Hanania, Rabbi Yossi HaKohen, Rabbi Shimon ben Netanel, Rabbi Elazar ben Arach. 5 students. And he told them, I'm going to give you a task. And I want each of you to go out of Beit HaMidrash and to find for me what is Midah Tovah, what is good value. And I would take after you give me, but I said, no cut and paste. People, when they read the Mishnah, they think now it's a competition, who is the best student of Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai, but which is completely wrong. All what he said, you know, you are, you know, when he said like 5 fingers, remember we talk about fingers, and you are 5 students, each one of you is a finger, but 5 of you is one hand. And I would like to see each one of you and to combine and harmonize each one of you, and then to build up a methodology how to teach people to make Tikkun Olam, what is really good value. And that's what he said. And each one of them went to, you know, to look for and search what is good value, what is Midah Tovah. They knew that the word Tov, good, start with the letter Tet. In order to find what is really the letter Tet, they knew they have to look for the first letter Tet in the Torah, and from there they will learn what is good value. So first I will tell you what each one of them will say, and then I'll bring Bnei Yisachar and remind you how each one of them came to this conclusion. So Rabbi Eliezer Omer, Ayin Tova. Rabbi Eliezer ben Hurkanus said, good eye. Rabbi Yoshua says, Chaver Tov, good friend. Rabbi Yossi Omer, Shachem Tov, good neighbor. Rabbi Shimon ben Netanel omer, arue et hanolad, the one who can see the future, but literally the one who can see the birth of something that was born. Arue et hanolad. Today, arue et hanolad is an expression in Hebrew to see, to predict the future, to see a few steps ahead. Rabbi Elazar ben Arach said, Lev Tov, good heart. As we see that among the five, Rabbi Shimon ben Netanel is really, you know, is outstanding. Because everybody say Tov, 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 Tov. Means Ein Tova, Shachen Tov, Chaver Tov, Lev Tov. Okay? So only Rabbi Shimon ben Netanel said Haroet Anulad. And today, Rabbi Shimon ben Netanel, he is our hero today. What is Haroet Anulad? The one who can see the future. The one who can see the birth of something. And but let's see first of all how Rabbi Eliezer came to Ein Tova. So we found out that the first word letter Tet is the word Tov. Tov, good. When God created the light, it says Vayar Elohim et haor ki Tov. Okay? Vayar Elohim et haor ki Tov. And God saw the light, that it is good. So now, each one of them, they knew from this pasuk, they can learn what is midat tova, what is good value. So vayar Elohim, and Hashem saw. So Rabbi Eliezer said, to see, you need eye. So he said, good eye, ein tova. His friend, Rabbi Yoshua, says, you know, the darkness and the light was combined together, connected. You know how to say connected in Hebrew? Mechubarim. Mechubarim is chaver, is a friend. So he said, chaver tov, good friend. And then after him came Rabbi Yossi, Amar, you know, and Hashem, what he did with the light and the darkness when they mixed. Vayavdel Elohim et haor ve et hachoshech. Hashem separated the light and the darkness. So the light and darkness became neighbor, shachen. So he said, Shachen Tov, good neighbor. Let's keep Rabbi Shimon ben Netanel. Let's go to Rabbi Elazar ben Arach. Rabbi Elazar ben Arach says, Lev Tov. Why he said, where he got the word Lev, heart? He counted from the first word of the Torah all the way to the word Vayar Elokim et haor ki Tov. He counted how many words we have. Bereshit bara Elokim et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz va-aretz hayta tov vavohu ve-choshech al pnei tehom ve-ruach Elohim merachefet al pnei ha-mayim. Okay? Until vayar Elohim et ha-or ki. One word is said before tov, ki. He counted how many words? 32 words exactly. And you know, 32 in Hebrew, gematria, the word is lev. Lev is lamed is 30, bet is 2. Lev is 32. So he said, Lev. And Vayar Elokim et haor ki, what after ki? Tov. So he said, Lev Tov. So he said, Lev Tov. Okay, you can say it's nice, gematria, it's nice abbreviation, but look at the depth. When Rabbi Elazar ben Arach, he said to Rabbi Hanan ben Zakkai, said, I see everything you said is included in Lev Tov. Everything you said, because he said, you know, good eye, good neighbor, good friend, can see the future, because everything you said is included in the 32 words already. So the 30 words of Rabbi Elazar ben Arach, what he said, Lev Tov, is inclusive. Included everything you said is inside Rabbi Elazar ben Arach. But why he said Lev Tov? Lev Tov, you know that right now we're counting the Omer. And how we divide the count of the Omer? The count of the Omer, you know, now it's morning. We do not shave, we do not get haircut, no wedding, because of the 24,000 students of Rabbi Akiva. And everything stopped, you know, in Lag BaOmer. Lag BaOmer is only the stop of the epidemic of students of Rabbi Akiva, is also the end of the morning, and it is also the day that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, he himself went up to the Shamayim, and he revealed the entire Zohar, the entire Kabbalah. He was allowed, he got permission to reveal the entire Kabbalah. So we have now, if you know in the Bar Shebar Yochai Nimshachta Asherecha in the poet, And he says we have lev netivot, that we have 32 paths to go to higher yourself, to go to the Kabbalah, to Hashem. And now listen what is lev tov. Lev is 32. Huh? Tov is 17. If you say lev tov, 32 plus 17 is 49. That's the 49 days of the Omer. So we said now lev tov, when you start lag ba'omer, lamed gimel is after lev, we have 17 good days that going straight all the way to Matan Torah. Matan Torah is the 50th day, is above number 7, is 8. We learn about this, is above nature. And that's why he said lev tov. We'll talk about this Mishnah later on, but that's the idea. I would like to go to Rabbi Shimon ben Netanel, that he himself said, you know, lirot et hanolad. What is lirot et hanolad? You know that we have a mitzvah to believe in Hashem. One of the things that it is very hard to digest, because we have no capacity in our mind, in our intellect, even to digest it, that Hashem is zukseh mahadesh betuvo bechol yom tamid ma'aseh bereshit. Hashem is renewing with his goodness every day the creation of the world. You know what does that mean? Let's take Yehi Or, where we mention. When Hashem said Yehi Or, he did not stop to say Yehi Or. Every second, he renewed the creation of the light. If Hashem will stop 1 second to say Yehi Or, can 1 second, no light. And we say it every morning, and we don't know what we say. He said, Am Hadesh Betuvo, Bechol Yom. Bechol Yom is every day. But not every day, every minute, every second. Betuvo, in his goodness, because it's a chesed that Hashem is doing with us. Ma'aseh Bereshit, it's not only the light, the entire creation. And now we have, how we, human being, can digest this process and believe in this every minute. How we do? You know how we do? Let's go now to the Isha Yoledet. Remember the woman who delivered a baby. If we go to the woman that delivered the baby, what we see, let's go to the room, you know, to the room. Many of us been privileged to be with his wife, you know, when she delivered the baby, or the woman, of course, that she was. So we have the lady, the nurse, that helping, you know, to deliver the baby. And we have the wife and myself and the husband, and we see the baby. When we see the baby, you know, it's one of the most amazing moments that we have in life. Why? We, haroe et hanolad, the moment that the baby is out, we see the nolad. That's the nolad. We see them something that was born right now. And I tell you one more thing about this. Is not only we see the real creation of human being, I realize now that who really brought this baby to the world? Three partners. Is me, my wife, and Hashem. So my wife and me, when we see this step, and we come to conclusion that we are partners of God. We both created a new human being now. And that's what we call the Roe Tanolad. And if we want to know what is Roe Tanolad, we all have to go to the delivery room. When we go into the delivery room, we'll see the Nolad. And I would like to give you an example how we can come and digest and even understand with our intelligence this Roe Tanolad. Let's say you go into a big, busy street. In Yerushalayim, I would say Rehov, Yafo Street, or Ben Yehuda Street, King George Street, or go to Tel Aviv to go to Allenby Street, King George, Ben Yehuda, the same names, the same streets are very, very busy. Okay, I'm walking now, and I see buses, taxi, cars, pedestrians. I mean, a lot of things moving. north, south, south, north, east, west, west, east, and everything. And I have now to believe that every second Hashem create this scenery. How could I do this? So listen to this. This is not so hard. But this is amazing. You know what that? Stop on the sidewalk. Go to the side. To the side. Don't walk. Look with open eyes to what you see. The busy, busy street. Now close your eyes and deliver yourself now. You have to make not hypnosis, but meditation. You know, go inside delivery room. And now you, when you're closing your eyes, you are in a delivery room. And you really, you know, you hear the noise of the cars and this, that says the contractions of the woman. You know, you see all the noise and the noise and the noise. After 30 seconds, 40 seconds, open your eyes. You know what you see? You see again, traffic, busy street. No, you saw the Nolad. When you close your eyes, you're in delivery room, and now you parallel the street to the delivery room. And that's what Hashem is doing during every day, every minute, to renew the creation. So the whole our life is delivery room. If we want to understand, you know, what is Roeta Nolad, we have to go and to take this woman that you go into the delivery room. That Roeta Nolad. So it's amazing. So this Isha, this woman, gave us the power and the potential to understand what is Mahadesh Betuvo Bechol Yom Tamid Ma'aseh Bereshit. Now, I would like to see it go back to our parasha. We finished with the Mishnah. And I would like to see what this woman is doing today and what she will do if Bet HaMikdash, the temple, you know, Be'ezrat Hashem will be rebuilt. Or what we did when the Bet HaMikdash was. Today, the delivery woman, the one who delivered a baby, every woman, say, Hagomel. What is Hagomel? Thank you, Hashem. Thank you, Hashem, that I'm alive. I almost died, you know, in the delivery room. It was very, very difficult. And Baruch Hashem, I'm alive. So we say Hagomel. So I thought, what is the best thing if the Bet HaMikdash would be today? Today, we have a sacrifice called Todah. Thank you. So I thought, you know, the woman take Korban Todah and say Korban Todah, Todah Hashem, instead of Hagomel. Beautiful, no? No. That's not what our parasha. I'm opening the Chumash, and I would like to read to you exactly what, you know, what the Torah is telling us to do. Vayikra Yudbet. Is Vayikra chapter 12, Yudbet. Ken? And he said, the pasuk is, Uvimlot Yeme Tohora Leven Olevat, after she is pure, and she delivers son or a daughter, it doesn't matter. Tavi, she has to bring, listen now carefully, Keves ben Shenato Leola, sheep, lamb, for Ola, for Korban Ola, and Yona, ben Yona Ehad Otor, and Tavi a dove, for Hatat. Did you hear? This woman that gave us another human being to the world, that we have to salute to her. Her Torah said you have to bring two sacrifices. One Ola, one Hatat. And he said, you know, one Ola said, you know, why this woman, if the Torah would say, let's say Korban Todah, it makes sense. But why she has to bring Ola and Hatat? Hatat is het. Is because of a sin. Is this woman make a sin? She made a sin. This woman, she made a big mitzvah. She helped her husband to make the mitzvah of Piryah v'Riviyah. She brought another human being to the world. And he said, Korban Hatat. Why we say this? So Hazal, our sages, bringing this question, and as a fact, we mentioned Rabban Shimon Bar Yochai, his student even had difficulty with this. And they say to Rabban Shimon Bar Yochai, Rabbi, why this woman is to bring Korban Hatat? Why? What did she do? And look what he said. Besha'a shekora'at leled, kofetzet venishba'at shelo tizakek lebala. Okay. sorry, I just closed the door. B'sha'a shekorat laledet, you know, when this woman, when she had the contractions, when she had the pain, you know, the last contraction, you know, she said, not anymore, not my husband, not delivering baby anymore. She made a swear, she swore that she is not going to deliver baby anymore. So, and because of this moment that she had the pain so hard, even it was not in conscience, it was subconscious. Because after she see the baby is like the Mashiach for her. Is a boy or a girl, it doesn't matter. For her is a Mashiach. For the father, for the husband is the Mashiach. And she's so happy, she changed her mind. She wants another baby. He said, hey, you made a neder that you're not going to give her any baby. This is a sin. This is chet. Chet is you missing. You know what you missed? You missed the most important point. It's called this moment of blindness. Remember the word blindness. This moment that she could not even see very clear because of the pain, she made this swear. And because of this swear, she has to bring Korban Chatat. And now why Korban Ola? Korban Ola is the opposite. When she saw the baby and she's not under pain anymore, and she see the baby, you know, by the way, Korban Ola is the Korban that the Kohen doesn't take anything, that Ole, it's come the word elevate, moving up. The entire Korban going to Hashem. Every piece of the Korban is going to Hashem. Nothing is to the Kohanim, nothing is to human being. Everything Ole. Everything is elevated to Hashem. That's called Korban Ola. And now this woman, when she saw the baby, and she realized something very important in her life. By the way, I want to say, deliver woman, that woman deliver a baby, the woman, is each one of us. Remember what we learned in Ar Shiurim, that we learn something, what we can take to our life. So this, we're talking about the woman who deliver a baby, but we all deliver babies. We all have contractions in our lives. And we all have blindness sometimes. But he said she realized, you know, that she is really nothing. She realized that en od milvado. She realized she is partner of God. The moment that she realized that she is partner of God, everything is from God. If not Hashem, she is nothing. That's now she feel elevated. When the man or woman in our life, when we realize that en od milvado, and all what we do in a mission in this world, and we are just messenger of God, and God is everything. Everything is godly. So now this woman, she understood that this boy or a girl is godliness, is alokut. This delivery, this deliver room is godly. This bed that I am sent is godly. Everything is godly. Everything is alokut. When she realized this, she's so happy that she has the potential to understand it. And she feel elevated. Because she feel elevated, you know, to Hashem, she bring Korban Ola. So let's have conclusion to see what the difference now between Ola and Hatat. Had la Ola v'had la Hatat. Because now the Hatat, he said, Ola is because Hashem gave us the power, gave the woman the power to see clear that en ol midvado, that everything is Hashem. Nachon, that's what we said right now. And Chatat is just the opposite. Chatat is to bring Korban that I miss the sight. I miss the vision. Remember the word I said, remember blindness? Now I was blind for 2 seconds. That was my blindness, my Ivaron. I could not see. Because I could not see. So we said, you know, we have 2 korbanot. We put them on the scale. But, you know, we're all going through this chatat. We're all going through this moment that we don't see God. We all see, you know, that we think that the world is going to collapse. We're all going through this. It's happened in our subconscious. It's not. But he said, you know what, how to fix it? Fix it with Korban Ola. You know, the Korban Ola is coming and fixing the Korban Chatat. And that's why they combine. That's why this woman giving Korban Ola and Korban Chatat. Now, after you know, we finish with this, I'd just like to conclude this. You know, we the word crisis that we mentioned a few times, the word crisis. The word crisis not always coming, you know, it's coming negative, you know, meaning, the word crisis in Hebrew, mashber. But we have to understand that the word mashber is something good. Our sages said that Hashem make chesed with human being, that once in a while we're going through crisis. Because what happened when we have crisis? Now we have the corona. We have crisis. But believe me, from this crisis, we were revealed how much potential we have inside us that we don't believe we can do. We can do many things. We can do even Leila Seder, only my wife and my husband. Just look, I'm thinking about this Leila Seder. It's funny, but it's really, you know, that's Hashem's will. What can we do? I myself plan, we plan, my wife and me, and all my kids. I have 4 sons, and Baruch Hashem, we have 11 grandchildren, and all of them were supposed to come to our house for Leila Seder. We cleaned the house, we prepared bed, we did this, and all of a sudden, the corona came. Now that he said, you're not allowed to be together, he said, you're not allowed to fly, you're not allowed to do this. And now, in my age, even they said, you cannot see little children. So I said, oh, all what I said, I closed my eyes, I brought myself to the delivery room, and I remember, you know, the delivery room, and opened my eyes, said, "Hadesh betuvo bechol yom tamid ma'aseh bereshit." He said, you know, this crisis, you know, we have the potential to realize and come to actualization, the potential, and to see how much power we have. We have so much power we don't even realize. That's the chesed that Hashem is doing. So now, after, you know, the crisis, we will see, as I said, Be'ezrat Hashem, the light of the Mashiach. We will see the Bereshit bara Elokim et ha-shamayim et ha-aretz va-aretz va-yomer Elokim yi or. Now, you know what Rabbi Shimon Benetel, Shimon ben Netanel said, Haroe et ha-nolad. Haroe et ha-nolad va-yara Elokim et ha-or. This light is not the light that we have today from the sign. This light that Rabbi Shimon ben Netanel said, you know, the Torah said, it is the light of the Tzadikim. And Hashem hid this light, we call it hidden light, Ha'or HaGanuz. And he said, Be'ezrat Hashem, one day, you know, I'll give you this light back. Why? Because we have no capacity, you know, to take this light today. We're not so strong. We have to prepare the tools. We prepare ourselves, you know, to see, to accept the light. It's like somebody who put his finger in the outlet. You cannot take it. There is no capacity. You get the electric shock and you might die. Chas v'shalom. You don't play with fire. You don't play, you know, with the fire of God. But he said, Be'ezrat Hashem, Rabbi Shimon HaRoeh, Zehu HaZomer. You know what is midah tova? What is good value? He says, HaRoeh et ha-nolad, the one who can see the future. You know what is the future? The future is the Or HaGanuz, the hidden light. He said, this hidden light will come. And now, I would like to tell you something very nice. The last 2 minutes to conclude. You know, usually when we end up Aliyah, we have to end up Aliyah in the Torah with something good. We cannot do it with something bad. What is something good? So we say, you know, Yishereach Necho Al Hashem, you know, Hashem, something good. And then Baruch Hashem, all the Aliyah divided the way that the end of the Aliyah is something good. Now let's take the last pasuk of the Torah. That's the end of the Torah, not only. They said, Le'enei kol Israel, to the eye of Israel. Rashi, so the last word of the written Torah is Israel. Le'enei kol Israel, to the eyes of the entire Jewish people. Le'enei kol Israel. And Rashi says, is the story that Moshe Rabbeinu broke the 2 tablets, and Hashem told him, Yishar kohacha sheshibarta. You know what is Yishar kohacha? Chazak uvaruch. Yishar kohacha sheshibarta, that you broke the 2 tablets. He gave him Yishar koach for this. Hazak uvaruch for Yishar koach, for shibur. And what the last word of the Torah Shebaal Peh? Shibarta. So you see the word shibarta is mashber. It's kind of the word mashber, crisis. He said, don't worry, because you know, he said, you know why the last word called Israel? He said, you could not take my first 2 tablets because it was the handwriting of God. And we, as I said, we had no capacity to take the light of God. The second two tablets, Moshe himself took and he wrote so we could have and digest and consume, you know, the capacity and the two tablets, the second two tablets. But the first two tablets, it still belonged to us. How you prove that it belonged to us? What can I do? If I take, you know, I have here a glass of water. If I take this glass of water and pour it to the ground, did I steal? No, it's mine. So how you prove something belonged to you? You can break it. So when Moshe broke the two tablets, he proved to Hashem, because they had a fight. Who is the owner of the two tablets? Hashem said, it's mine. Moshe said, no, you gave it to me already. It's mine. Hashem is pulling one side and Moshe is pulling one side. It is very hard to say it, if not the Talmud Yerushalmi said this. And Moshe won. When Moshe won, Hashem said, you know, the Torah belonged to the ground, to you. And he said, Yishar kochacha sheshibarta. Now listen to the last, the punchline. You know, in Simchat Torah, when we finish the Torah, we have Hatan Torah. The one who finished the Torah is Hatan Torah. And the one right after Torah, we finish, we start Bereshit. Bereshit is Hatan Bereshit. We have two grooms, two Hatanim. My parents were born in Yemen. We, the Yemenite, we don't have a Mek Bracha. The Hatan Torah finished Le'enei Kol Israel. Hatan Bereshit is going to the Torah, which was standing behind him. He doesn't even give Bracha. He said, Le'enei Kol Israel, what the next word? Bereshit bara Elokim, et ha-shamayim et ha-aretz. So listen, what is Le'enei Kol Israel after Moshe broke the two tablets? Let's start from Bereshit, from scratch. Everything, Zeharoet ha-nolad. We are going to the deliver baby. We renew the world. And you know what we're doing since then until today? We prepare ourselves really to accept and receive the first two tablets. Rabotai, we prepare ourselves real good. And we deliver, you know, we go into the delivery room. And we close eyes, remember, every minute Hashem is renewing the world. Amhadesh betuvo, that's why we have Kiddush Levana. Because the Levana is the best creature to show us what is renewing. We are going in the beginning of the month, the first 9 days, to make Kiddush Levana. And we see the Levana in the beginning, almost nothing. Very hard to see her. But, you know, after a week, we can see like banana. We can see, you know, the crescent of this. We're going toward the 15th of the month is a full moon. And then after 15, 16, it starts to shrink. So what the Levana is teaching us? That Hashem is renewing the world every minute, every second. So Rabotai, if Bezrat Hashem, as I said in the beginning, let's light the candle in Elohim Neshamar Behaim Vital. Let's go to the delivery room. And we will start Bereshit Bara Elohim. And you know when Hashem Bereshit, remember 32 words? Vayomer Elohim Yehi Or, Vayehi Or. Hashem said, let's be a light, and the light was good. This light is the light that will come by Bezrat Hashem tonight. When I said tonight, is very, very soon. This light, when daughter of Paro opened the Teva, and to see Moshe the baby, she saw the light, you know, in the Teva. That's why she knew that Moshe is very tzaddik. When Moshe was delivered in the delivery room of Yocheved, Yocheved knew that Moshe is a big tzaddik. How she knew? Because she saw the light Ora Ganuz in Moshe's face. Moshe Emet, Torato Emet. And Be'ezrat Hashem will see the Mashiach Tzidkenu, B'mera B'yamenu, Amen. Speedily in our days, Amen. Chodesh Tov, good month. And next week, Be'ezrat Hashem will celebrate, will commemorate the Israeli soldiers who died, and will celebrate the birthday of the State of Israel. We'll talk about this next week. Leitraot, Shabbat Shalom.